Welcome to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now today I'm going to talk about the incident where a popular selector, a man by the name of, who go by the name of Slaughtertone, lost his life on Mullines Road, right, Saturday gone. Right. He's normally based in Atlanta, from what I'm understanding, right, but he visits Jamaica regular. Right. People know him as a man where always, anytime he's up on the island, you know, him doing flossing or him managing business them, cause he actually own quite a few bus and taxi and them thing there. So, you know, him go back on foot. Well, he won't be going back now, because he lost his life in Jamaica. Just like that. See, as I was reading the story in the papers, even without getting the details, we could already have an idea how it go. We're gonna pick up the usual clues then. I just the setting different and the names them different. Right. But let me tell you the usual clues. So he was at a bus garage, as me say, more enough bus and them thing there. Probably a check one and bus them or whatever. Right. He leave the bus garage and get a phone call. And then him left out, say him go check a female. As he was driving along, right, in his lovely dropped up BMW, I guess enjoying the breeze, enjoying the sights, him never know say that'll be the last drive it may ever take. Because some man pulled up on him on Mullines Road and decided that he was gone. But me, I wonder about this phone call thing and meet up with female thing. Because as we know, that's the number one program in Jamaica. That's the most common program running in Jamaica. But I'm sure the police investigators them already look into it. Probably calling the female already. Or try find out who made the call, because these things I'm gonna notice are the same thing over and over. Somebody they one place, somebody call them, they move on to one next place, and then them things happen to them. You can't be a stranger call you. Right. So once the police then find out who call him or who they go meet, they probably can put two and two together. Who knows, I'm just saying, it looks spooky. I just see him story over and over again. And so far, everybody who know him, I mean, you know, so them surprised because they know of him having, you know, because, for example, when you know, so when you come from a certain place, or you come from a certain ends, and you have, you know, so you and them man over here, so, you know, things, and then something happened to you, people say, well, oh, well, you know, so him and so on, so, you know, things. People have said, they really know of him as a man who, you know, involved and like that. People have said, they know him mainly for, you know, him flossing and him girls, them and, you know, the luxury lifestyle and them things that they really know him for. Right. So, don't really have a motive right now, but of course, as usual in time, everything will come out. But what it comes down to is that when people see cases like this, especially people who live abroad, them say, see, that's why I'm not going to Jamaica. Because this man was relatively successful. Right. Having vehicle him on the road and, you know, drive up and down with him, drop that beam on, whatever the case may be. The facts are, he visited Jamaica, his homeland, and he ended up dead at Jamaica. He never losing life or foreign. He go back home, thinking, say, same as usual, pass through, flossing, link up and, who forget link up and, over here, and go over here, and go back to America, all them can go back on the plane. So when people see them things, it just reaffirms enough people say, see, that's why. Nah, touch back a yard. And even though personally, I don't think nobody should ever resign themselves to the idea that they won't ever return to Jamaica. But when people come to that conclusion, we can't really blame them. Because you might say, okay, oh, you know, so you're involved in that things. Well, we don't, but it's not like, say, these things all happen to people who, quote-unquote, involved in that things. These things happen to 60, 70, 80 year old people will return. Right. The motives have been far and wide. There's no consistency here. It's not like, say, people who go back to Jamaica and lose them life, the whole of them did mix up. Sometimes people lose them life for all kind of foolishness. People need to understand that it doesn't cost much to lose their life in Jamaica. One big argument, one disagreement, man tell us if you give him the same, say you're not give him. Man was suffer from the girl coronavirus, but you say, somebody see him girl and you drop that bima. Next thing you know, him start size you up. Right. So it don't really cost much. Or it don't really take much. If you end up, don't have made a rest. But I just want people to understand, say, these cases put off enough people in the diaspora from visiting Jamaica again because them see just so easy. Somebody who have links, have money, have connection can get take out. As me say, I don't know what the motive, but you would think Jamaica would be a place that people can just visit and just move on freely. And just, well, there was actually a time when that's how it used to be. Come to think of it, there was a time when you could just fly out, work for 1, 2, 3 years, then touch back a yard, move around freely. Now if you watch your head back, there was a time like that, but no. All people were mixed up in that foolishness, nervous. I say, you know, Jamaica serious. Now one time in Jamaica, people used to kiss them teeth. Half of violence now. I say, well, me and the bad not in a nothing. Me not mix up in a nothing, so I'm good. There's a time in Jamaica where if you're not directly involved in a badness, you can walk up and down as free as you feel like, you know. Now it look like, say, all civilians won't have nothing to do with badness. If you walk and I watch it back. That's how you know time serious. People won't have no known rivals and no known enemies. Touch a Jamaican if you look over shoulder 10 times and you have to make sure so the carrier come pick them up, another carrier, and then make sure so the molly stop right there, so, and all if they want to drink one jelly, then can pull up on the side. That's serious time. Somebody missing me there and tell me, say. They miss the days when time, then goes left airport, right? Tie up all the much suitcase, pan back a vehicle, and just cruise and stop and pull over. Right, and drink a coconut and eat a food and the suitcase them in the car or upon the van back and they just laugh and a joke and take them time go in. When I tell me say last time I touched Jamaica as him walk out of the airport, it look like say it look like the car don't ease up till it reach a country. Right. Non stop, nobody not stop again. But no one somebody go a glimpse the suitcase and start follow them and trail them and all kind of things, and next thing you say people can't find. Nobody not supposed to have to live so. You shouldn't have to live so in your own country. You shouldn't have to live so in a country where you're born and grow. That is how you behave when you go to a foreign country. That is how you behave when you go. If somebody tell me, it's alright, go on over that country that way, and you know the culture, you know the people them, so you are tipped to wanna make sure everything alright. That's how Jamaicans are here acting in Jamaica. How can Jamaicans feel safer a foreign than in a Jamaica? Jamaicans feel safer a foreign all in the deep south. Or some places where them have no cultural similarities with other people, them feel safer this than in a Jamaica. How that? People realize there's something wrong. Nothing can go so. Everything have to be like you go upon some kind of criminal operation. Regular citizens have to be a tiptoe like say them a thief. So you know when thief go somewhere, they have to make sure it's alright. I can't linger here, so I can't go here, so I don't want to get catch over here. So that's what normal people have to think. Normal people have to look around the corner and them something that can't work. You can't have a society like that. You can't have a society where you live, the residents, normal people are living in constant fear. That's no way to bring up pity and have no kind of real joy. Right? You walk up on the road at night time, right? People have to look around the corner and tiptoe like them are wanted, man. Normal people. society can't go on like this. People supposed to can left the country, do what they want to do, make all the money they want to make, and come back to Jamaica and walk around Jamaica freely. Build what they want, build, buy what they want, buy. And after your worries, the man come knock on them door and tell them, say, give me this and give me that. I think I get it then. They used to then go and listen. Man. Foolishness. Foolishness. It's have to change. Man. Jamaica have to change. I can't remember Jamaica being like this when I was young. Remember one time, as I said, I didn't want much slaughter tone, but when I was young, foreigners used to come to the place and live normal, normal. Walk up and down and look for your body and sit up on the corner, drink with them and drink and then go about in business. That was normal, but not anymore. Anyway, Patreon squad, big up on yourself. PIA, you don't know, more life. Vulture squad, stay circling. Bless.